Good morning, Banner.
Good morning.
I have Mrs. Winslow with me today, and before we get started, I've got just a little bit of trivia about Mrs. Winslow. But let's let her introduce herself. What do you teach, Mrs. Winslow?
I teach second grade.
And how long have you been teaching? Kind of give me a little bit more.
Do you want the whole history?
Yeah, and a quick nutshell.
This is my 23rd year of teaching.
23 years.
I've been in the district 16 years.
Okay, talk louder.
16 of those years I've been in the district. Starting at Dunlap High School as a special ed teacher, moved my way back to elementary as a resource teacher, and then this is my third year teaching second grade.
Wow. Well, let me tell you a little trivia about Mrs. Winslow that maybe you didn't know. When I was a senior at Pekin High School, Mrs. Winslow was a freshman at Pekin High School. We didn't know each other back then, but we kind of figured that out. And I look back at my yearbook, like, sure enough, she was in my yearbook. So a little trivia for you there.
So that means you're older than me.
Just a little bit, yes, yes, okay. Of course. Yep, for sure. You've got some birthdays you'd like to announce today?
I do.
Okay,
we
let's
have
do those.
A lot of birthdays, so
great.
Bear with me. This week, we have in 4-H, Kalea Taylor. In 4-B, Molly Smith. KB, Quincy Sonnemaker. 1A, Brendan Weber. 1A as well, Samutha Sarum. Sorry if I said your name wrong. And then our staff members, we have Mrs. Gallette, who works in the cafeteria and serves us all that delicious food. Thank you, Miss Kathy. We have Mrs. Mason, who is one of our literacy aides. And then we have one of our fifth grade teachers, Mrs. Young. And then this weekend, starting with Casey, we have Sydney Katie. In 3S, we have Max Thorpe. In 4-H, we have Meredith Wagner. And then my teaching partner, Mrs. Baker. So happy birthday to all those students and staff members.
Happy birthday, everybody. Hope you have a great, great week of birthdays. And you mentioned Mrs. Gallette. And you know, there was something really cool this week during the lunches. There were these awesome, like, potato smiles, but they were in, like, emojis. Did you see them?
I did.
They were awesome. I mean, check them out. Aren't they cool?
Yes.
They are so cool. So I hope you guys like those. I don't know if they tasted better than the others, but boy, they were entertaining.
I think they had to have tasted better.
Yeah,
right?
I think so. Go ahead.
I saw several of the kids trying to impersonate the emojis, so that was a lot of fun. So, fun with their food today.
Very cool. Very cool. That was awesome. That was awesome. Hey, you may or may not have noticed, but I am not actually here today. I'm gone for a couple of days. I'm learning about some technology things that teachers can use. I'm up in Schaumburg, Illinois, which is up near Chicago. So I will be back on Wednesday. So I'll see you guys then.
Okay. We are welcoming Mrs. Bloomer back this week. Yay.
Yes.
She's coming back from a maternity leave. So welcome back, Mrs. Bloomer.
All right. I bet her class is Mr.
Yes, I'm sure.
Yes. All right. Welcome back, Mrs. Bloomer. Oh, and you know what? We actually have 5 days this week, students. You've had all these snow days and these teacher institutes, but happy 5-day week. We're looking forward to working with you for all 5 days this week.
It's good to have them right here for 5 days.
Yes. Tonight, parents, there is a PTO meeting at 6 o'clock, so we hope to see you there. It's going to be more of a working on the carnival type meeting. Tuesday night from 3:30 to 5:30 is our kindergarten registration. We're going to have some kindergartners coming, and I cannot wait to see our new kiddos come. So that is this Tuesday night from 3:30 to 5:30. Parents, if you have any friends or neighbors, spread the word, get them here, okay? We want to get as many kindergartners as we can here. What else do we have going on next week?
Well, this Friday, Mrs. Volker's class is going to Walmart to go shopping, which is I think they always have a good time.
Mm-hmm.
And also this Friday, March 1st, in the afternoon, we're having our reading day, Mr. Fairchild.
Reading day? What are we doing for reading day? What does that look like?
Well, it's very similar to math day. So if your student has come home and talked about math day, so we take the afternoon and we split classes K through 2. They get to rotate through other classrooms and they get to read. And then 3rd, 4th, and 5th also get to rotate through those classes. So,
like doing fun things with reading?
Fun things with reading.
Reading can be fun?
Reading. Yes.
I mean, I like math a lot, but reading can be fun too.
Yes.
I love it.
So
I love it.
We look forward to that, and it's always fun to see all of the different kids from different grade levels.
Awesome. Awesome. Looking forward to that on this coming Friday. Okay. PTO is selling. This went home with your child last week, I believe it was last week, but this form right here It is a yearbook form, and you can buy this, oh, this lovely yearbook. It is all color, and it is $17. And it, parents, if you're asking, well, didn't I pay for that with my registration fees? The answer is no. This is the only time that we send out the order form. So if you would like a yearbook, it is $17. All the information is on the form right here. If you are missing it, just give the office a call, and Mrs. Barbara's always happy to help you out there. So that is coming up soon. Okay. All right. Yes.
And then I hear Mr. Fairchild, you guys, principals on parade. Also, Friday's a busy day.
Yes.
And you guys are doing your principals on parade at Dunlap Grade School.
Yes. So I'm going to go visit Dunlap Grade School. They call them the Royals. And so we're going to go check out the Royals. And we have a couple students that used to go to Dunlap Grade. So you know all about the Royals and that group. So yes, we'll be heading there on Friday. Looking forward to that.
Can I ask you a question?
Sure.
What is your favorite thing about going the principals on parade? Your favorite thing about going to the other schools?
Boy, you know, it's just, it's nice to see other ideas, what other schools are doing. And it's really neat to see like a lot of the same things that we're doing, other schools are doing as well. And it's great to see all the excitement in the district from all of the kids, from all of the schools. And I like to sit down and ask kids questions when I go there. So I like to talk to kids. You guys know that probably. Yes. So, but thanks for asking that. Looking forward to that. So
I missed you while you're gone, but
have fun. I've been gone a lot, I feel like. So, hey, I think it's that time. It is time for the joke of the week.
It is. I'm so excited. I actually have two.
Okay.
Okay, I'm going to need your help with this one.
Okay.
Two of my students, I asked all of my students, and those that wanted to submit a joke of the week submitted a joke, and then I drew a couple out of a bucket.
Okay.
So the first one, Mr. Fairchild, mm-hmm. did you hear the joke about the spy?
No, please tell me the joke about the spy.
Oh, I'm so sorry. I can't. It's top secret.
Oh, cha-ching. All right.
Yes, we do need one of those.
Yes, yes.
Okay, that was from Maya Hendrickson, by the way.
Okay.
Who's in
good job, Maya.
And then I also have one from Jay Larson. You ready for this?
Okay.
All right. What do you call someone with no body and no nose?
No body and no nose. I have no idea what you call someone with no body and no nose.
Nobody knows.
Nobody knows. I love it.
Thank you to
very
all of
good.
My students for submitting those jokes and to my two lucky students that were drawn.
That's awesome. That's awesome. Great jokes. And I hope you all have a great week this week. And Banner, always remember, you belong here.